I thought we'd do something a little different. We called it Keep It Simple tonight. We're going to do a pasta salad. I've cooked rotini noodles and drained them. I've made two batches, one with the color noodles. They have tomato and spinach noodles in them. And the other one is just the plain rotini. A little tip, if you are like in a hurry and you're making pasta salad, I knew that was going to happen. If you're in a hurry and you're making pasta salad, you can take a dishcloth, a dry dishcloth or paper towels, and you can dab dry your pasta just a little bit, and your dressing will stick to your pasta just a little bit better if you're in a if you're really in a hurry. All right, so I have cooked my rotini noodles. This is super, super simple. Best recipes there are. A bag of matchstick carrots. Shredded carrots. If you want to shred your carrots, you can put about 4 or 5 carrots, shred them up and put them in. Nancy, can you take care of that? Thank you. All right, I've cut 1 green bell pepper. Green bell peppers are beautiful this time of year. And I have cut 1 onion, and we still have a few Vidalia onions, so I was lucky to get a good flat Vidalia onion today. So we're going to mix all that together. Now on the other one, I also added broccoli. Broccoli is always a hit in pasta salad. Just whatever you want to throw in it, maybe some grape tomatoes. Right before you serve it. This pasta salad, you can serve it right now, but it is better if you let it set 4 to 24 hours. So I'd throw the tomatoes in a little closer to time to serve. So this is 1 box of pasta cooked. So if you don't want to do rotini noodles, you can do something else. All right, so I've mixed that up. Now I'm going to skip on over, and I'm going to put in my bowl 1 can of sweetened condensed milk, something just a little bit odd in pasta salad. You knew I was going to have to find something different. It's good. Don't trust me. I see that look. Yeah, and sugar. All right. So we're going to take 1 cup of sugar and put in here also. 1 cup of distilled white vinegar. So we've got a few different little things going. And then we're going to have 1 teaspoon of salt and 1/2 teaspoon of pepper. And we're going to whisk that together.
That looks good.
That vinegar takes away a lot of that extra sweetness. It's sweet, but it'll take away. Now, if you want to use Splenda, you can use Splenda. Do you know what fried cornbread's called?
Fried cornbread.
It's called hoe cakes.
Okay. Is that what we're having?
You could cook. They used to be cooked on a hoe over a fire.
On a hoe?
Yeah, a real hoe. A real hoe. But they're called hoe cakes. And we're just going to put this over top of our pasta. I love fried cornbread, by the way. All right, and we're going to stir that right up. So if you don't care for mayonnaise, this is a great alternative. And it has a little bit of a different taste, obviously. But it's very good. It's different than what you would imagine it to be. You know, I've made some sweet pasta salads and fruity pasta salads and fruity coleslaw, but this is really good. So then you just take this, and if you're in a pinch, you can go ahead and before you start mixing all this together, you can get your pasta really good and cold. There we go. And this is your pasta salad. Let me get the other one out and show you what the one with the broccoli and regular rotini looks like. We have a lot of pasta salad to eat tonight. And this is our other one. And when we go to serve it, just stir it up and it is ready to go. But you would never know that that had sweetened condensed milk in it.